Hello friends, welcome to Vashtech channel. This is Vasant Naik from Vashtech channel. Today we will see one more concept, flag register. Exam question is explain flag register or different types of flags in 8086. So 8086 contains 16 bit flag register, but it has got only 9 flags here. Flags are classified into conditional flags and unconditional flags. Conditional flags and control flags. Conditional flags are, these are the conditional flags. Carry flag, parity flag, auxiliary flag, zero flag, sign flag and over flag. And control flags are trap flag, inter flag and direction flag. Condition flag means based on certain condition, these flags will be activated. For example, zero flag. Zero flag will be activated. Zero flag becomes one. When the arithmetic logical arithmetic operation results in zero, carry flag will be activated when there is a carry. But control flags, interrupt flag will be activated whenever there is an interrupt. These are called as control flags. These are called as condition flags. So in the exam you have to write like this, and the order should be same. Like 16 bit, in that starting 4 locations are reserved, and some of the locations are undefined. U means undefined, but remember it starts from 11th bit, and ODITSZ, then space A space P space C, APC. Remember some order to write. If you write your own order, that will not be considered. So starting should be carry, then parity, then auxiliary, like this it should proceed. So now you have to explain what are these flags. Carry flags. Carry flags will activated when there is a carry from 7th bit to 8th bit. 7th bit to 8th bit. Please remember, 7th bit means we start with the D0. So when we start, normally we start with the D0. When you start with the D0, see here only I can say 7th bit. When you start with this D0, D0 to D8, 8 bits are there. That means there is a carry from 8th bit to 9th bit actually it is. So since we start with the D0, you can say there is a carry from 7th bit to 8th bit. Then carry flag will be activated. Parity flag. Parity flag indicates the number of ones in the data. If even number of ones are there, even parity. If the odd number of ones are there, odd parity. So parity flag is one. If even number of ones, parity flag is zero. If odd number of ones, odd number of ones. Similarly, auxiliary flag. Auxiliary flag will become 1 when there is a carry from the 3rd bit to the 4th bit. Please remember. See, I am using this, instead of drawing once again, I am using this itself. There is a carry from 3rd bit to 4th bit. Then auxiliary flag will be activated. Zero flag will be activated when the results of arithmetic operation results in 0. For example, 6 minus 6, it is 0. Then 0 flag will become 1. Student will write 0 flag will become 0. No, 0 flag will become 1 when there is arithmetic operation results in 0. 0 flag will become activated. Activated. It is activated. Otherwise, 0 flag is 0. Please remember this one. Sign flag. Sign flag is used for sign number. It indicates whether the number is positive number or negative number. If the number is positive number, then it is 0. When the number is a negative number, then it is a 1. Similarly, interrupt flag. Whenever there is interrupt from the external device, interrupt flag will be enabled. Trap flag will be used for debugging purpose. And direction flag indicates, overflow flag indicates whether the number is in the out of range or in range in the calculation. These are the different flags. So now you can see in the exam they may give example, add this one and show the results of flax. So here when you add, first of all you convert this into binary. Individually you convert, 3 you convert into binary and 8 because it's the hexadecimal number, 2 and this one. When you add this one, so here you can see there is a carry from 4th bit to 5th, 3rd bit to 4th bit. So auxiliary flag is enabled, there is no carry from 7th bit to 8th bit. So carry flag is 0 and parity flag is 0. That means there is a odd number of 1s. Odd number of 1s, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, odd number of 1s. 0 flag is 0. Because result is not 0, so that's why this 0 flag is a 0. Sign flag is 0 because it is a first number. Sign flag is a 0. So sign flag is 0 because you can see here D7 bit is 0. This indicates sign bit 0. If it is a 1, it is a negative number, but here it is a positive number. So that is the one case. Second one, you can see here, I am going to move 9C to AL, 64 to DH and DS to AL. I am adding this one. Then what is the result? Carry flag is 1. Carry flag is 1. When you add this one, carry is there, carry flag is 1. Carry is there because carry flag is 1. Second, auxiliary flag is also 1 because there is a carry from 3rd bit to 4th bit 1. Parity flag is 1, even number of 1s in the result, even number of 1s, we can treat this as even number of 1s. So 0 flag is 1 because the result is 0 and sign flag is 0. Sign flag is 0. D7 of the result is 0. Sign flag is a 0. D7 of the result is 0. Sign flag is 0. Similarly, we have other exercise problems. You can go through it. Please go through it. Go through your notes and you will find. You can take here one more example here. Here you can see. This is the move AX. I am going to move 94C2 to AX and I am going to move 32 to BX. I am adding this one, AX and BX. Similarly, I am adding AX to DX, AX to CX. What is the carry? This one. So, here you see this is 16 bit number. When you add the 16 bit numbers, then what is this? So, individually you have to write and you have to see whether there is a carry flag is there. So in this case you have to take a D15 for carry flag, not 7th bit to 8th bit, D15 bit. So there is no carry from the D15 bit. Auxiliary flag is 1, of course 4th bit to 5th bit, I think there is a carry. So parity flag is 1 because even number of 1s, even number of 1s are there here. Since there is an even number of 1s in the lower byte. So please remember this one. Parity flag is 1. Since there is an even number of 1s in the lower byte. When the 16 bit number considers, you have to consider this one. 0 flag is 0. Since the lower byte result is 0. And sign flag is 1. The D15 of the result is 1. Sign flag is 1. That indicates it's a negative number. So, dear students, we will consider the previous problem here. Sign flag is here 1. So sine flag can be, actually it is not negative number here. Sine flag can be ignored because sine flag indication also depends on the overflow flag. And in this case, there is no overflow, so this can be ignored. But sine flag indicates here it is a 1. That doesn't mean that is a negative number. So now other than that, we'll move to what is the use of zero flag? Very, very important. What is the use of zero flag? Zero flag is used for looping. Why looping? What do you mean by looping? You can use it for to perform looping operation. How you can use it for to perform looping operation? Like whenever you can use the counter, and whenever counter reaches zero, then zero flag becomes one. When the zero flag becomes one, then you can come out from the looping. That is called as looping. In the diagram, you can see here. CX is 0,5, and I am moving certain value, and I am moving certain value to AL, and I am adding content of BX to AL. I am incrementing BX and decrementing CX. Whenever CX becomes 0, then it will come out. Otherwise, jump no 0. That is, if the 0 flag is not activated, then it will repeat the loop. Otherwise, it will come out. If the zero flag is activated, that means it has reached the maximum count and it will come out from the loop. So that is the use of zero flag. Zero flag can be used for looping purpose. Please remember this one.